Today we'll see the megaloblastic anemia. So what is meant by megaloblastic anemia? So megaloblastic anemia, it is a type of, anemia, and which is characterized by very large sized red blood cells and decrease in the number of these cells. So what is meant by megaloblastic anemia? Of course it is a type of anemia. So what is anemia? Anemia, it means decrease your hemoglobin or the RBC. So this megaloblastic anemia is a type of anemia, or it is a form of anemia, and which is characterized by a very large sized RBCs, that is very large sized red blood cells, and decrease the number of the cells. And this megaloblastic anemia is occur due to the first, that is deficiency of vitamin B12, and second, that is deficiency of folic acid. See here I am repeating, this megaloblastic anemia is caused due to first, that is deficiency of vitamin B12, and second, that is deficiency of folic acid. And this loss of micronutrient may also be cause this megaloblastic anemia, or the loss of micronutrients, it also causes the megaloblastic anemia. Then the copper deficiency, it causes or result from an excess of zinc from unusually high oral consumption of zinc containing denatured fixation cream has been found to be a cause. It means another cause for this copper deficiency. Then this, the pathological state of this megaloblastosis is characterized by many large immature and dysfunctional red blood cells, that is megaloblast, in the bone marrow, and also by a hypersegmented neutrophils, that is defined as the presence of neutrophils with 6 or more lobes, or the presence of more than 3% of neutrophils with a less 5 lobes. Then yes, in pathological state of this megaloblastosis is characterized by first, that is many large immature and dysfunctional red blood cells, that is megaloblast, in the bone marrow, and second, that is also by a hypersegmented neutrophils. So it is defined as the presence of neutrophils with 6 or more lobes, or the presence of more than 3% of neutrophils with at least 5 lobes. So this pernicious anemia is a type of megaloblastic anemia in which body isn't able to absorb the vitamin B12 due to the lack of intrinsic factor in stomach secretion. And this intrinsic factor which is required for absorption of vitamin B12. See here it is important, this pernicious anemia is a type of megaloblastic anemia in which the body isn't able to or unable to absorb the vitamin B12, and due to the lack of intrinsic factor in a stomach secretion. So what is role of this intrinsic factor? This intrinsic factor which is required or which is essential or which is needed for body in order to absorb the vitamin B12. So this is the basic of megaloblastic anemia. So what is megaloblastic anemia? It is a form or it is a type of anemia in which what will happen, or it is characterized by a very large number of or very large sized red blood cells, and decrease the number of the cells. And in this, or this megaloblastic anemia is occur mainly due to the first cause, that is deficiency of vitamin B12, and second, that is also the deficiency of folic acid. Then also the loss of micronutrient is also the cause of this anemia. Yes, then next, that is pernicious anemia, it is a type of megaloblastic anemia. What will happen in pernicious anemia, in which there is our body isn't able to absorb vitamin B12, and due to this due to the lack of intrinsic factor which is in a stomach secretion, and this intrinsic factor which is helpful for the body in order to absorb or for the absorption of vitamin B12. Then second, that is etiology of the, so what is etiology? It means the causes of this megaloblastic anemia. The megaloblastic anemia most commonly result from a acquired nutritional deficiency or the inability to absorb the nutrients. Yes, it is most commonly due to the acquired nutritional deficiency or the inability to absorb the nutrient. In that first, the causes include, in first, vitamin B12 deficiency. In that, this vitamin B12 deficiency is occur due to the first cause. Acylohydria induced malabsorption, then deficiency intake, then deficient intrinsic factor. So what is intrinsic factor? It is a molecule which is produced by cell in the stomach and which is required for, yes, which is required for what? Absorption of vitamin B12. That is pernicious anemia. Then colic disease, then biological competition for vitamin B12, then selective vitamin B12 malabsorption, then chronic pancreatitis, then nitrous oxide anesthesia usually required repeated instances, then folate deficiency. That is in folic acid deficiency which occur due to the first, that is alcoholism, then second deficient intake, next increased need in following condition. For example, the need of or the requirement of this folic acid which is increased in few condition, for example in pregnancy, the infant, then rapid cellular proliferation and cirrhosis. Then next cause, that is malabsorption. Then intestinal and jejunal resection. Then deficiency of thiamine and factors or the enzyme which is responsible for metabolism of folate. Then third, that is combined deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid. In that first cause, inherited pyrimidine synthesis disorder, for example aortic aciduria. Then inherited DNA synthesis disorders, then inborn genetic mutation of methionine synthase gene. Then next cause, toxins and drugs. This megaloblastic anemia may be caused due to the, or may also be developed due to the administration of antimetabolites that affect the production of DNA directly, such as chemotherapeutic and also the antimicrobial agent. For example, azathioprine and trimethoprim. Then folic acid antagonist, for example methotrexate. Then phenytoin. Then next nitrous oxide. Then pyrimidine antagonist, for example cytarabine. Then next, that is symptoms. So what are the symptoms? The most common symptom, that is fatigue, and also the symptoms are vary from person to person. In that first, shortness of breathing, then fatigue, muscle weakness, abnormal paleness of skin, glossitis, it means swollen tongue, then loss of appetite, weight loss, then diarrhea, nausea, fast heartbeat, smooth or tender tongue, then tingling in hand and also tingling in feet, then numbness in extremities. These are the few symptoms of this megaloblastic anemia. Next, that is pathogenesis. In that, what happened? This megaloblastic anemia results from an inhibition of DNA synthesis during red blood cell production. See here, basically, what is this megaloblastic anemia, which results from inhibition of DNA synthesis during red blood cell production. And when this DNA synthesis is impaired, then what will happen? There is cell cycle, or the cell cycle cannot be progressed from G2, that is growth stage, to the mitosis, that is M stage, because this DNA synthesis, because this inhibition of DNA synthesis is impaired, then what will happen? There is the cell cycle, it cannot be progressed from this growth phase to the mitosis phase, or the mitosis stage. And this leads to, or this causes the continuing the cell growth without division, and which present as a microcytosis. And this megaloblastic anemia has a rather slow onset, especially when compared to that other anemias. And this defect in red cell DNA synthesis is most common due to the decreased supply of vitamin, and especially vitamin B12 and the folic acid. Then, in bone marrow, the most megaloblasts are destroyed, and prior to entering the peripheral blood, that is intramedullary hemolysis, and some can escape the bone marrow, that is macrocyte, to a peripheral blood, but they are destroyed by the reticuloendothelial system, and this reduces the number of red blood cells. I'm repeating, see here, in bone marrow, the most megaloblasts are destroyed prior to entering the peripheral blood, that is intramedullary hemolysis, and some can escape the bone marrow, that is macrocytes, to peripheral blood, but they are destroyed by the reticuloendothelial system, that is extramedullary hemolysis, and this reduces the number of red blood cells, that is RBCs. Next point, that is complications. So what are the complications of vitamin B12 deficiency? First, that is neurological changes, that a lack of vitamin B12 can cause a various neurological problems. For example, vision problem, memory loss, pins and needles, then loss of physical coordination, that is ataxia, which can affect a whole body and causes the difficulty in speaking, and also the difficulty in walking. Then damage to the part of nervous system, that is peripheral neuropathy, particularly in the legs. Then if neurological problem do develop, they may be irreversible. Then next, infertility. Then stomach cancer, that is pernicious anemia. It increases the risk of stomach cancer. Then neural tube defects. In that, first, for pregnant woman, not having enough vitamin B12, it increases the risk of developing a serious birth defect known as neural tube defect. Yes, for pregnant woman, if vitamin B12 is not getting sufficient quantity, then there is increasing the risk of developing a serious birth defect, and which called as neural tube defect. And this neural tube is a narrow channel that eventually form the brain and the spinal cord. Yes, this neural tube is a narrow channel, and that eventually form a brain and spinal cord. Some example of this neural tube defects, for example, spina For example, spina bifida, that is where is the body's spine doesn't develop properly. Then next, that is anencephaly, it means where the baby is born without part of brain and the skull. Then encephalocele, so where the membrane of the skin covered sac containing a part of brain push cut off a hole of the skull. So next, that is complications of folate deficiency. In that, first infertility, then cardiovascular diseases, cancer, problem in childbirth, and neural tube defects. Yes, complications in folate deficiency, first infertility, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, then problem in childbirth, and neural tube defects. So this is all about the megaloblastic anemia. So simply, it is what? It is a deficiency of, or it occurs due to the deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid.